We saw at the beginning of the lesson what are the goals of refactoring. But what are the reasons why we need to refactor in the first place? The first reason is that requirements change. And when requirements change, we often need to change our design accordingly. In other cases, even if requirements don't change, we might need to improve our design. And this happens for many reasons. For example, we need to add a new feature, we want to make the code more maintainable. And also in general, programmers don't come up with the best design the first time, so they might need to adapt it after the fact. And the final reason I want to mention is sloppiness and to some extent laziness of programmers. And a typical example of this is something that we all have done, which is copy and paste programming. So instead of rewriting a new piece of code, because we know that there is some code in some other part of the program that does a similar thing, we'll just copy the code over. And before we know, we end up with tons of copies of the same functionality. And when that happens, a good way of consolidating that code and extracting that functionality is to use refactoring, for example, by creating a method or a class that provides that functionality. And we'll see specific examples of that. Now, a question I would like to ask at this point of the class is whether you have used refactoring before. So I want you to take a second and think about it. And no matter what your history is, if you ever coded, I bet you any money that the answer is yes, you have done refactoring. What do I mean? I'm going to give you an example. I'm sure you renamed a class or a method or changed the name of some variables in the code before. That's a refactoring. Even something as simple as renaming a class is a refactoring because, for example, it might help you making your code more understandable. And of course, I'd admit that in this case, this is a trivial refactoring, and there are much more interesting ones.